Hypothesis test for a mean in Excel. Hi, I'm Dr. Nick from Creative Maths, including Statistics Learning Center. This is a video to show how to use Excel to perform a hypothesis test for a mean. We will use the same data we used in the video calculating a confidence interval for a mean so that you can see where the numbers come from. In this case, the orchard owner is comparing the mean of her apples with the export standard of 152 grams per apple. She can see that the mean weight of the apples in her sample is about 149 grams. Could that just be by chance that the apples in the sample are mostly lighter than the ones in the whole orchard? Or is there evidence that the mean weight of the apples in her orchard is less than 152 grams? The null hypothesis is that the mean weight of the apples in the orchard is 152 grams. The alternative hypothesis is that the mean weight of the apples in the orchard is less than 152 grams. Because we are only concerned if the apples are too light, we will do a one-tailed test. If we were wanting to know if the mean weight of the apples was different from 152 grams, then we would perform a two-tailed test. In our video hypothesis testing, we gave five steps. They are hypotheses, significance, sample, p-value, decide. We have our hypotheses. We will use an alpha value or significance level of 0.05, and we have a sample of 15 apples ready to analyze. So the next step is to calculate the p-value using Excel. Excel does not do single sample tests for a mean, so we need to be a bit sneaky. Open your spreadsheet. Make sure you have the data analysis add-in. Your data needs to be in columns with run row for each observation. In this case, each row corresponds to an apple with its weight. Make another column with the value from the null hypothesis given twice. Our hypothesized mean is 152. In a cell away from the data, enter equals t.test open brackets. Highlight the data, comma. Highlight your comparison numbers, comma. Enter 1 for a one-tailed test. Then 3, as this is 2 sample unequal variance. And, hey presto, here is the p-value of 0.021519, which we will round to 0.022. I will finish off this hypothesis test using this p-value and then come back and show you a longer way in Excel that will give the same result. This will help you to trust the answer. The p-value is 0.022. This is less than the alpha value of 0.05, so we reject the null hypothesis. Our conclusion is that we have evidence that the mean weight of apples in the orchard, the population, is less than 152 grams. Now let us see where the p-value comes from. Click on the Data tab, and then the Data Analysis Tools. Select Descriptive Statistics. Put in the input range, include the title at the top, and select labels in the first row. Click on Output Range and select the cell in the top row to the right of the data. Select Summary Statistics. And here we are. We wish to see how far the mean of the sample is from our hypothesized mean in terms of standard errors. So we calculate the sample mean minus the hypothesized mean, and we find that it is negative 2.73333. Next, we divide by the standard error of 1.228 and get negative 2.22494. That is saying that the sample mean is a bit more than two standard errors below the hypothesized mean. The t-distribution is pretty similar to the normal distribution, so we know that anything more than two standard errors away from the mean is a little unusual. We find out what is the probability of getting a value of negative 2.22494 or less in the t-distribution with 14 degrees of freedom. The degrees of freedom for a one sample test for a mean is the sample size n minus 1, in this case 15 minus 1, which gives 14. We use the t-dist function to find out what the probability is. Not surprisingly, or happily, the probability is 0.021519, the same as the p-value we found previously. And now you have two ways to calculate the p-value for the test for a mean in Excel. Please ask questions in the comments below. Click the like, subscribe, and click on the bell for notifications. Happy statistical analyzing!